In this video, I want to talk about the differences between Apple's AirPods and Samsung's new Galaxy Buds Live that were recently introduced. Now, we will be talking about the standard AirPods, but I also want to bring in the AirPods Pro, since its features are more comparable to the Galaxy Buds Live. And we're going to cover three different categories: design, features, and best and worst, where we compare the strengths and weaknesses of each headphone. And of course, we're going to start with design. Now, these Galaxy Buds Live are very striking. They're very unique looking. Some people think it looks like jewelry in a jewelry box because of their high reflectivity. But a lot of people are calling them beans since they do resemble kidney beans. And although it has a unique appearance, people are saying great things about how they feel. It sits inside the ear instead of outside like many other headphones. It uses cartilage to stay secure, which people are saying very good things about. There are no awkward stems like with the AirPods. And because of that, people are saying it has a more natural appearance. Now, how does this stack up to the AirPods? Well, on the left, we have the standard AirPods, and those sit partially inside the ear, partially outside. It uses cartilage to stay secure, which a lot of people like, and it has that long stem that we're used to seeing. On the right, we have the AirPods Pro. Those sit mainly outside the ear, and they use pressure to stay secure, and this is a really important point to consider. When you push AirPods Pro in your ear, they sit deep inside your ear canal, just like earplugs, and that pressure is what holds it in place. And this has led to people complaining that if they're sweaty or they use AirPods Pro for a long period of time, they will slowly slide out of their ear and they have to push them back in. That's actually happened to me. And it has a shorter stem than the standard AirPods, but it does still have one. And again, just because the AirPods Pro don't work well for me or the regular AirPods do, every ear is different. It may be different for you. The only way you can know for sure is by testing these headphones out in person. Next, I want to talk about something important to a lot of people when shopping for headphones, and that is their availability in color. The new Galaxy Buds Live come in this mystic bronze, which Samsung has really been hyping up, and they also offer a white and black option. That's something Apple does not offer with the AirPods. Both the standard and AirPods Pro models are offered in white. That's it. There's no black, there's no color options, although people expected Apple to offer the AirPods Pro in black. That's still something they're not doing. Next, let's talk about the features of these headphones, and let's break it down with a comparison. The AirPods Pro offer active noise cancellation, industry-leading technology that a lot of people love. AirPods do not have that technology. The Galaxy Buds Live do have active noise cancellation, but many reviewers are saying that the tech Samsung is using for this feature is not very good, and they can barely tell when active noise cancellation is on compared to off. Next, the Siri voice command is available on the AirPods Pro and on the AirPods, but keep in mind, this is only supported for Apple devices. If you're pairing AirPods to your Samsung device, you will not have this feature, and the same is for the Galaxy Buds Live. It supports Bixby voice wake up, which is only supported on Samsung devices. Next, the AirPods Pro have an in-ear custom fit. They sit deeper in the ear canal and they offer different ear tips. AirPods have a standard universal fit. They do not have different ear tips. The Galaxy Buds Live, though, do have an in-ear deeper ear canal fit with a custom ear tip to choose from. Next, the AirPods Pro are sweat and water resistant. The AirPods are not. The Galaxy Buds Live are. Next, the AirPods Pro offers up to 4.5 hours of listening time. The AirPods up to 5 hours, and the Galaxy Buds Live up to 5.5 hours of listening time. But what about the wireless charging cases? The AirPods Pro offers an extra 24 hours of listening time. AirPods, same 24 hours. Galaxy Buds Live, an extra 20 hours. Now I want to talk about something that's important to a lot of people when buying headphones, and that is, how do you set these things up? Well, there is one-tap pairing, but only for devices within the ecosystem. For example, if you have an iPhone and buy AirPods, you will get one-tap pairing. If you have a Samsung device and you get the Galaxy Buds Live, you will get one-tap pairing. But if you have an iPhone and buy the Galaxy Buds Live, you will have to go into Bluetooth and manually connect them just like any other third-party Bluetooth device. And the same is true on Samsung. And that brings me to a really important point, and that is ecosystem. Whether you are in the Samsung or Apple ecosystem, you are getting benefits that you would not otherwise have. For example, the one-tap pairing that I mentioned, but also things like seamless switching between devices, which only works if all your devices are in the same ecosystem. So keep that in mind if you plan on mixing and matching your devices. Lastly, I want to talk about the best and worst things about each model of headphone. The AirPods Pro, the best thing about them, active noise cancellation. They have the best in the business. The transparency mode, best in the business. You get the ambient noise around you. It sounds very natural. You don't get that fishbowl effect like on other headphones. And it has reliable playback thanks to Apple's H1 chip. Lastly, great sound quality, probably the best out of all the headphones. Drawbacks though, color options are limited to white. Next, the inner ear fit may not be good for you. Keep this in mind. People are complaining about them sliding out, not fitting comfortably. I've had these problems, but I put an asterisk next to this because there are people who love the AirPods Pro and think they fit very comfortably. Next, AirPods, great feature, outer ear fit. A lot of people love how the AirPods feel. They're very secure. I can leave them in all day and I never have an issue. It has the smallest wireless charging case by volume, and it's the most affordable at $160. Lastly, it has that reliable playback with Apple's H1 chip, just like the AirPods Pro. But the drawbacks, again, it's only available in white, and the sound quality is the weakest out of all three headphones. Moving on to the Galaxy Buds Live, it has great inner ear fit. Many people are praising how it feels in their ear. It's available in colors. It's affordable at just $10 more than the cheapest AirPods. But there are drawbacks though. And one of them is its active noise cancellation technology. It's just not that great. It's very weak. It has spotty, unreliable playback at times since it doesn't have a processor like the H1 chip to ensure a reliable connection to your smartphone. And some reviewers are complaining about an overpowering bass that just muddies up the overall sound quality. So based on that information, I hope you can make a more informed decision on which headphone model is best for you. And again, I highly recommend trying out each headphone in person if you are making a buying decision, since what works best for me or a different reviewer may not be what works best or feels best in your ear. All right, guys, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe for more content like this in the future.